You'll have to excuse me, Lewis. I've not been too well over the last few days. Enough excuses. You must have heard the old joke about the bloke who goes to the doctor and says, "I go to the toilet at 7:45 every morning." And the doc says, "Well, what's wrong with that?" And the bloke says, "I don't get up till 8:00. Well, if he turned up here on Monday, he wouldn't have a problem. The roofers are coming. Now, for those of you who haven't been following the tale, why haven't you? Am I just talking to myself or what? The housing association must have some money they need to get rid of, so they're replacing the roofs on all the houses on the estate. And I watch these lads faffing about on the houses across the street over there. And from Monday, it's our turn. And just to back the story up a little bit, they actually put the scaffolding up a couple of weeks ago. Then the storm at the end of November struck and half of it fell down. Well, they've now put that right. And we had a knock on the door yesterday. It was the foreman. We started on your roof on Monday and we'll be here at 8:00 to turn your central heating off. Thanks. Middle of bloody December, they're going to turn up and turn the heating off. Oh, he said, don't worry. He said, we've got heaters you can borrow. I said, well, aye, we'll see how we go, but leave me your phone number. And it doesn't stop there. They turn it off on Monday. We're all right for Tuesday. And then they turn it off again on Wednesday. And apparently the way the system works is they rip the old roof off on Monday and put the new one on Wednesday. What the hell are we going to do on Tuesday? We'll have to do a roof. I can see us having a bedroom full of bloody water. Maybe go to bed in a wetsuit. Now I said, didn't I, that I've been quite ill over the last few days. Touch of enteritis. It's all right. You can carry on watching. You can't catch it through a webcam. I hope. Anyway, I've been really bad. But today is my wife's birthday. I'm not going to tell you how old she is, because I don't fancy living in the fairer wilds for the rest of my life, and that's as far as I'd have to go if everyone found out how old she is. But notwithstanding the fact that I am unwell, we had to go out today and treat her for her birthday. Right, so we went down to the supermarket, because I wasn't willing to go any further. I went into the cafe and she disappeared round the shop, treated herself. And we all know who pays the bloody bill, don't we? Well, she couldn't find anything in the clothing. She couldn't find anything in the perfumes and stuff like that. And they don't do jewellery. Am I stupid or what? Anyway, eventually she came back with a bottle of Campari, 4 cans of John Smith's bitter, and a bottle of drain cleaner. God knows what kind of bloody cocktail she's going to be mixing. So that's it. And of course, with it being a birthday, she expects me to be nice to her tonight. So I'm off to bed early. On my own. Be that as it may, with me being yuck over the last few days, I've not been able to get a great deal of work done. But I can say that Mrs. Capper is doing fairly well. And pre-orders for the next Sanford Third Age Mystery, a Deadly Twixmas, are doing okay. And if you're a Sanford fan, if you're not, why aren't you? If you're a Sanford fan, the launch event is now arranged on Facebook. Don't worry if I didn't send you an invite. I couldn't be bothered. Just invite yourself and turn up. But how many people are going to show up on the 23rd at 4:00 in the afternoon? I don't know. I'll be lucky if I'm there myself, especially if she's in a spending mood. And that's about it. Links and stuff will be on when I've done prattling, but right now I'm going to crash on the settee and get some sleep.